Chair, are there any nominations for Deputy Chair?
Councillor Paul Thomas, Chair.
I second that, Tom.
Thank you very much. Do you have any apologies for absence?
Yep, we've had Councillors Jones, Moorhead and Thomas.
Thank you. I did confirm that we are called to continue this meeting. Unfortunately, the notification was for the appointed people on the Honours Committee, but it's City Region only appointed Councillor Moorhead and Councillor Paul Hill on Friday, so the arrangements for their diaries passed. Wasn't it Councillor Paul Hill? It's here, and we can continue. Are there any declarations of interest? What's left for me is to thank the resigning committee member, Councillor Nina Killen. And obviously, when Councillor Jones arrives for the next one, I'll welcome them accordingly. Can we agree the minutes of the last meeting held on the 5th of April 2016? Move on to item number 6, Liverpool City Region Combined Authority Final Accounts 2015-16 pre-audit. John Fogarty will offer the presentation on this one.
Thank you, Chair and members. The accounts, obviously, presented before you on this day, the pre-audit at this stage, this is basically part of the audit process to invite scrutiny and challenge and from yourselves. The accounts present the financial position at the end of 2015-16. However, they present a lot more than that. It's accounts really are about assurance. We present the financial position throughout the year. This really gives yourselves, but more importantly, the public, the taxpayer, the assurance that those figures that we use are correct. And you know, the accounts are basically a closed system. Account balancing is how you know that the financial information that you're getting is correct. And the accounts presented here present a balance between the financial information you've got, the financial systems, and importantly the bank statement. So it relates it to, you know, all we've done financially this year is related to the bank balance at the start of the year and the bank balance at the end of the year. So there's some really important technical figures within these accounts that external audit will be spending the next number of months pouring all over. So you need to be happy with that assurance, but also I think you need to be comfortable with the balances within that, particularly within the reserves and cash balances, and also assets. And this will present to you a picture of what's happening in combined authority assets, whether those be physical assets or cash within the year. So what I just wanted to briefly do was just to present an overview of, I think, what the key elements of this are. So it's not a presentation, it's just a number of diagrams that should assist. This is really, it looks complicated. What I'm trying to do, it looks more complicated than what it's to look actually. This is really just to show where the CA's income and expenditure is. So I'm simplifying this because there are a number of other bits of income stream. For last year, the CA gets the transport levy, which it sets itself and is collected from the five districts of Merseyside, not from Halton. It also gets special rail grants of 90 million. It's responsible for the tunnel tolls as well. So the CA receives all those tunnel tolls income. And last year, there was £21 million of local growth fund money, which is the start of the devolution process. Now, that's all the CA's income. Its expenditure is very high. It's only a number of transactions, if you like. So it gave to Merseytravel a grant of £96 million for Merseytravel to carry on and fulfil its public transport requirements and obligations for the five Bolton for last year, under the umbrella of the CA, carried on with its own arrangements. So Bolton's council taxpayers paid 2.6 million and Bolton provided 2.6 million worth of transport. But that's just within the whole of the council tax construct. So it's not presented within those accounts, but it's important to notice from a governance perspective, it's still there. The special rail grant is an in and out. That's what the DfT give to the CA, and then the CA gives it to Merseytravel, who use it for the Merseytravel network. Merseyrail Electrics get most of that. There's a bit for admin and a bit for Northern Rail. We've got debt repayments, which are predominantly those, well, exclusively debts that were inherited from the former ITA to the combined authority as its successor organisation. Those debt repayments relate to any number of transactions over, you know, probably 20, 30, 40 and beyond years. It's just that it's treasury management activity, although within it there are debts that relate to Mersey Tunnel and its construction and various borrowings that were undertaken over the previous years. There's no new borrowing whatsoever occurred in 15-16. The tunnel, 27 million, is operating and capital programme for the tunnel. Again, the CA gives that to Merseytravel to do on the CA's behalf. And then the local growth fund monies is £21 million coming in and it's £21 million going out to various schemes. The CA's income is higher than its expenditure, and last year was able to put 27 million into reserves. Predominantly, that was some of it was a lot of it. 14 million you'll see is around use grant, not just local growth fund, but quite a. It's just around timing of delivery of certain activities and, you know, the grant we've received to do them. We've had to carry forward from one year to the next. And there is an element also around the surplus on the tunnel tolls that's contained within it. You know, the 27 million is not the tunnel toll surplus. I need to be very clear about that. But the tunnel toll surplus is contained within that. Those reserves are high. They've been inherited again from the ITA. So you've got £50 million in reserve for rolling stock, which is to do with the rolling stock. But hopefully the procurement of new rolling stock for the Merseyrail network, which as we know is very, very old rolling stock. We've been over a number of years, Merseytravel and the previous ITA, has been building a reserve up. The ITA holds a reserve for the infrastructure works that we think will be necessary to bring new rolling stock onto the network. So that would be a power upgrade, station platform changes, a bit of signalling improvements. The ITA holds that, and then it has other reserves which are for investment purposes in infrastructure, predominantly transport infrastructure. That 60 million will go into the single investment pot in the current year, which the CA has obviously been receiving reports on the last couple of CA meetings. That single investment pot will have that accumulated reserve, plus the gain share money from government, plus local growth fund. As you know, basically that's the raison d'etre of the CA, which is to turn that into investments in economic growth, whether that be transport, economic regeneration, housing. So it gives the CA a very good starting point, if you like, with those accumulated reserves. So just on to the next one. Again, in terms of understanding the accounts, we've got a column that says authority only, which relates to the city region combined authority, and then there's another one that says group position, and then there's a third column which adds the two up. The difference between the total and the combined authority is Merseytravel. CA effectively control Merseytravel. So what Merseytravel spends has to be articulated in the CA's accounts, but we have to do it in a column because you've got that which the CA controls directly, that which Merseytravel controls, and then a total group position. There is also a statement to accounts from Merseytravel, which we've not brought to here, but you know is available for you to look at, which is just the Merseytravel on its own, because C8, costs and income and assets, are those which the Combined Authority controls on its own outside of Merseytravel. And for 15-16, that was relatively a small amount of the total, because Merseytravel was doing most of it, and it related to activity around the tunnels and some debt repayments. It was the bits of the CA that the CA did that weren't passed through as a grant to Merseytravel. The group position, as I said, is Merseytravel. Dead importantly, the CA doesn't have any employees, or didn't have any employees last year. It has nominated statutory officers, but they're not employees as such, because there's no remuneration. All the employees that are shown within these statement of accounts are employees of Merseytravel, unless otherwise stated. But it's Merseytravel, not the CA. The financial position, again, I think I could skip over that because I mentioned that with the diagram. The balance sheet, in terms of the balance sheet, you've got income, you've got assets and liabilities. The assets of the CA are, in financial terms, the greatest percentage by far is the Mersey Tunnels and the approach roads to the Mersey Tunnels. There's also assets of Merseytravel that are shown in the group position. Would be, by value, the ferries and the landing stages, our travel centres, Liverpool South Parkway as well, or parts of that, and the long-term lease on this building is another asset. Then clearly you've also got current assets, which is the cash position. Cash position is, as you see, quite high for the group, very high. In terms of liabilities, most of it is related to that borrowing that I mentioned, which was inherited from the ITA, which is around 200 million. Includes the tunnels, but it's not just the tunnels, it's borrowing for all kinds of things over many decades probably. Again, just to reiterate, there's been no borrowing in the past year that we're looking at, not been borrowing. The other liabilities, it's quite a lot of them which are technical in nature and relate to the fact that Merseytravel holds the Combined Authority's cash on its behalf. It's held in a bank account that is controlled by Merseytravel, and its treasury management investments. We basically combine, for treasury management purposes, we combine the CA's cash with Merseytravel's to get a greater rate of return from having a larger amount to invest. And when we come to year end, we have to pick that on the account. It makes it very complicated than it actually is. The other liabilities are trading liabilities. They're on Merseytravel's debtors and creditors. The CA doesn't have debtors and creditors in that way, other than with Merseytravel. There's a cash flow statement. That's really important to accountants, to auditors, probably less informative to members of the public and other users. But it's that cash flow balancing each year that means that all the other notes in the accounts, all the other figures are correct. Because the cash flow statement basically takes the bank account at the start of the year, all the activities we've undertaken in the year, and then it needs to balance with the bank statements at the end of the year. And the auditors will look at that. But again, cash position is very high, so treasury management is a real big issue for us at the moment, particularly with Brexit. Movement in the reserves, we have a high position on our usable reserves. Those are the reserves that are backed up by cash, most of which, as I've mentioned, have come from ITA's previous decisions, and they're earmarked for specific purposes, although at this stage they're not committed, because it would be further decisions by the Combined Authority, but they are earmarked and they relate to risk and opportunity. So predominantly they relate to the risk of having the old railway fleet, because we are unusual because we control the Merseytravel rail electric concession. Makes us fairly unique, but it does mean we need high balances to keep that network running. And then other reserves I mentioned are around infrastructure, and the CA holds those reserves because of the need to rebalance local authority financing to generate local taxation. So we need to turn those reserves into schemes that will benefit economic growth, and that's really why the CA scores are technical, they're notional, they're not backed by cash, they relate to revaluation of assets and pension fund deficits. There's no cash behind those, we can't spend them. We have to recognise them in the accounts. But the cash position, you know, the reserves for Merseytravel and CA combined, still getting on for 94 million at the end of last year. So really very healthy. They increased by 27 million. Again, the surplus from tunnels last year was around 18. It was budgeted to be less than that, but we got greater throughput traffic last year. In the year we're in now, obviously the surplus will be much less because the CMA made that decision around fast tech and altering the tunnel tolls in 16-17. This is the 15-16 position. Merseytravel were able to give back to the CA around £1.5 million last year in operating revenue that was spent. So, as you know, Merseytravel has quite a significant efficiency and agenda. And the LGF underspend is worth also mentioning that we got £21 million from LGF. We were able to, in the year of accounts, spend 12 of that for a number of reasons. A couple of schemes weren't able to start until June rather than April. And we also had a lot of skills capital money, which, because of the early base review, we had to halt while the early base review was ongoing. And how we manage that and the spend is that £9 million gets spent on, has to be spent on capital in the year. So it was applied to some tunnel toll capital programme works that were already in the programme, and effectively that money that would have paid for those capital works will be put back in the pot next year. So the underspend grant isn't really, it's in the reserves, but it's only in there to move money from one year to the next. It's an accrual rate, basically. And again, if the next slide, which you probably won't be able to, it won't reproduce. I can send this round by email, but it basically is a table which should make the reserves. It just summarises some of the information that's in here, and the reserve is, it's showing you which reserves are combined authority, which reserves are Merseytravel, and what you can see from that is, as I said, there's a lot of infrastructure and rail reserves. If you unpick those, then the reserve position is probably more akin to what Cllr would say around, you know, working capital imbalances in order to sustain, you know, the business. So we've got capital reserves, and we've got reserves for modernisation within Merseytravel. And again, I will send this via email because I recognise that it's not come up very well. But I think that's pretty much all I would like to say on the financial side of it. It's probably worth picking up as well that there is the annual governance statement, which is around risk and assurance. It's broader sense, and I think what that governance statement is hopefully picking up some of the work of this committee in recognising that it is still very much early days for the combined authority. In the year of account last year, it was predominantly transport-related activity and expenditure, and as a result, the assurance was pretty much around, or it was derived from, the work of Merseytravel, Merseytravel's finance section, Merseytravel's internal audit section, with equivalent assurance being provided for Halton residents, from Halton, internal audit financial systems. And, you know, for next, for the year, we have to look forwards within the governance statement, as well as looking back. And I think, as you will understand, the significant issues that the CA is looking at this year are around managing both evolved funding streams, particularly as they are now not exclusively transport. Merseytravel provides an infrastructure for spending the transport resources, but there isn't an equivalent body in place for regen and housing. And again, that flows into the capacity building work that the CA is currently engaged in, and also looking at the constitution to make sure that that continues to be appropriate to governance arrangements that will put in place next financial year, and picks up the reserve strategy. And obviously with reserves of this scale, there is a responsibility for the CA to seeing some value from North Wales, and that is recognising the we sold them for more than that. That's recognising that we made a small loss on those rails that we purchased previously. But we're happy to get them off the balance sheet, really, and happy that they're being used rather than held in storage.
Thank you very much, John. With regards to the Merseytravel accounts, I know you said we don't receive them yet, but obviously as part of the group accounts, they have to be signed off. And obviously aware Merseytravel to have signed orders if you want to hold. Will we get somebody from that board to this committee to suggest that everything is as it should be?
Well, the key will be from the external auditors, who will, you know, if there are any issues within the Merseytravel accounts, they will raise them at the CA level because they are obviously in, you know, they're part of the CA accounts. But the Merseytravel accounts have been to, as you'd expect, the Merseytravel board. They will go to the Merseytravel audit and governance board in the next couple of weeks. And any issues that arise from that would clearly impact on the accuracy of the CA's accounts. There can't be any inaccuracies within the Merseytravel accounts that don't have any impact on the CA level because they're in that group. So yes, there are multiple ways in which any problems within the Merseytravel accounts would be raised at this level. The main one of being the auditor's letter and the auditor's assurance. At the moment, we're unable to provide assurance. It's the external auditor that provides the assurance for these accounts. But what we can do is provide assurance that there are equivalent bodies at Merseytravel providing the same role over the Merseytravel accounts as you are here. And that's really important because, as I said, the Merseytravel accounts are very inaccurate, and then by definition, so are the complaint authorities.
I know you mentioned the reserves in relation to the group accounts. They are quite substantial. Just for assurance for the committee itself, they are within safe guidelines, and there's no other limit provided. There are earmarked objects for those reserves. What we don't want to see is the public saying, well, they've got millions of pounds in reserves, and they're just sitting on them. You know, you need to know that they are being specifically directed to projects.
Yeah, absolutely. If there were no responsibility for rolling stock, then I think you could look at the reserve position and quite rightly say that it was excessive. It isn't, because we've got that rolling stock, and we've got the obligations of the combined authority in terms of promoting chemical growth. The other thing that's worth saying as well is that this probably also needs to be looked at in the context of what's happened with the levy, the transport levy in the last couple of years. The transport levy, as you know, has gone down from 127 million to 105 million in 2 years, so that's a 22 million reduction. And what that has, and that's been achieved through Merseytravel making significant efficiencies, but it's also been achieved by playing some of those reserves back into the organisation in order that, you know, the burden on the taxpayer, the council taxpayer, has been relieved. So some of the capital financing reserves that Merseytravel
committee self-assessment of the good practice. We carried out this self-assessment with the help of internal audits, Stephanie. It was quite useful. It was useful for the members to actually know where they stand on what's expected of them, what training is required. Stephanie can give you a bit more detail of where we should be going.
Thanks, Chair. So as you said, with the previous members of the committee, we had a workshop where we went through these two self-assessments. These documents are provided by Cllr as best practice that the committee should assess its own effectiveness and consider where there might be areas for development. So we undertook that back in May, and both the assessments are there with the conclusions of the group, and those that were not present on the day gave out their input outside of the workshop. So we've got the whole opinion of the committee. And you'll see paragraph 3.5 on my report here that the areas of training that were identified that came out of that were around risk management, treasury management, and financial and performance reporting. They were the areas that the members felt they wanted to look forward to. So what we will do during the year is we will implement these forms of risk management and treasury management training for the committee. In terms of financial performance monitoring, what we agreed was that the quarterly financial performance monitoring report would come to this committee. So you'll see, not looking ahead, but you'll see from agenda item 9 of the forward plan that we've built that into the forward plan now, so that report will come as a matter of course. And then obviously any other training needs or general training that the committee feels that or development that feels it might want during the year, we can obviously address you during the year through yourself, Chair. But this is just so you have the control of the backward looking assessment that the previous committee did.
Thank you, Stephanie. As I said, it was a very useful exercise for the committee members at that time. Obviously, we've got to change the committee members for the coming year. I would say it's highly likely that there will be fairly changes to the committee structures throughout the combined authority as the combined authority develops. And I think we'd be preempting training for members of the committee when I don't feel like this is the final members of this committee the year going forward. I think that there's opportunities for the committee to be expanded to achieve the best outcome.
Chair, but again, we'll be happy to take questions if there's anything you want to go through in any detail. Thank you. resource. So if needs be, we could draw upon those things. But I do think it's very much a watch and brief, and that should there be a need for there to be additional resource, that's something that we would either have to go into this committee or to the Audit Risk and Governance Board of Merseytravel in terms of that allocation of data that exists within Merseytravel's plan. So at the moment, I feel quite confident that we've got sufficient resource to deliver the plan as is, but as you correctly say, should additional things come to us, then we will need to be mindful of that and reactive to that and responsive to that as swiftly as we can be. But currently, I think we've got sufficient to provide enough assurance to the combined authority through the plan of work that we've already established that this committee approved on the 5th of April.
Thank you very much, Stephanie. It's good to know that we've got a contingency built in there. So what's left for me to do on that item is to move the recommendations in paragraph 2 of the report. Is that agreed? Thank you very much, Stephanie, for your attendance. Thanks for the